You know how I feel. Ooh, 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 ooh.
Sweet. There I am. Okay. Hey, everybody. Welcome to welcome to Monday Night Hoop Path class. I can't believe that I'm starting on time. Believe it or not, this has been amazing. For those of you that have just been, if you haven't been keeping up, or not, why would you? But I developed a new way of setting up, and it has drastically reduced my setup time and then also just become much more reliable. And so this is like the third or fourth class that I've just been waiting for you guys to get here instead of this mad panic. So I'm in a great mood about that. And thank you guys for putting up with the sometimes tardiness of the starts. I definitely want to get in a habit of by 7:10 being in sway. So and maybe even sooner. That's right, not running on Hooper time anymore. I want to say welcome to everybody that is here. I love it when you comment. It's cool to see the same names. And if you were watching this from the Hoop Path Facebook group, you are going to show up as just Facebook user. If you want to, there are some reasons that you might want to watch it if you're watching on Facebook in the Facebook group, but I'm not into that. I'm not really, you know, knowledgeable of cybersecurity and why it's better, but somebody told me that sometimes it's better, but whatever. If you're watching from a Facebook group and you want to have your profile and name show up when you post, you have to consent to Restream, which is the service that I use here. Like it's one or two click through type thing, and then you can do it. I'll send you the link. I don't really think it's a big deal. Hardly anybody watches that way, but that's why, if it shows up Facebook user. You could do it yourself if you wanted to. You could go to Restream, but I'll send you a link if you're really interested. This whole class started a long time ago, a year ago now, almost, when the lockdowns started. And I was teaching a weekly class and have always taught a weekly class forever, and since 2005, actually. And I mean, except for when I would go to Canada to tour, it was an every week thing. Through the holidays, whatever. And so it's been really natural for me to just keep teaching through this, but I totally didn't think it was gonna go this long. But I've always taught this class with you guys kind of like I do my weekly class. And in my weekly classes, after, you know, since 2005, there are certain types of classes that come up in the rotation. And actually, what I have noticed over time is that students actually like the rotation, so they do like revisiting a type of class. And tonight is one of those classes called, I call it a guided flow class, which is kind of, it's kind of a contradiction in terms, by the way, that, you know, I define both of those things. But in actuality, what it is it's like a little bit of guidance. What I'll do is I'll make a suggestion for a technique that you work on. You find whichever technique you think, or your version of that technique, and then you work on it. And then tonight I'm gonna try to bounce around, although I'm open to suggestions. I was gonna throw that out there, but I have some songs and exercises already picked out. So it'd be something like shoulder hooping to a whole song, whatever. So for my more flowy type Hoop Path students that would rather I shut up and just put music on, this is kind of your type of class. It's a little bit more guided than a Piace class, if you guys remember what Piace classes are, because in this class, you're at home, you can do whatever you want to, but I'm thinking that you're doing the techniques with me. Oh, there's K Swift, sweet. Okay, if I've missed you guys, in the comments, my bad. Oh, there's Ann. Ann was participating last night in the jam, and I appreciate that, Ann. And then she also taught a class. Ann's starting to teach beginner classes again. So if you guys have friends that you want to get into hooping and stuff like that, you know, Ann's teaching super beginner-friendly classes. Okay, so I want to just jump straight into it. Tonight's playlist is already on SoundCloud, and I'll make it public at the end of class. And so if you, I forgot, honestly, guys, the Zoom room is up. Okay, cool. I forgot, honestly, to tell you guys or to realize that until yesterday that you guys can't really tell if it's SoundCloud or iTunes because of the way I'm putting it up there. So I'll try to be a little bit better about that. Let me switch back. I want to switch back and show you guys something here, just for mostly for people on replay. So Future Hero, if you look down in the socials there, Future Hero Podcast, that's my SoundCloud. Okay, I don't do that.
You know how I feel.
That's my SoundCloud. And there is where the majority
you know
of
how
the
playlists
live that are on SoundCloud, you know which is probably about 60 or 70% of them. So, and then the other thing you can do, like some people ask me, how do you discover music? And it takes a long time to build up SoundCloud's you know, algorithm or whatever. But one of the things you can do is if there's an artist you like, you can see what they like. Like you can go to their likes on SoundCloud and you can look through it. And it can be a great way to discover music, you know, or hear the artists that your artists are listening to. Okay, so let's go ahead and get going. Is here. Welcome. Audible breath in. Tonight, I invite you to sway with a word in mind. Tonight, the word is open. Maybe for you in this moment, it's an adjective. Maybe for you in this moment, it's a verb. But I invite you to repeat it to yourself in your mind. Or even if you're alone, to hear yourself say it as you move. Open. let it mean what it does tonight. What does it mean right now? As you say it. Open. Is it describing something? Is it directing something? Hey, Katie. Okay, sweet. So we're going to move into our first exercise. And, oh no, I did that thing. Hold on. Okay. I know every Hooper here has done this before. when you plug something through your hoop. Oh, okay. Here we go. There we go. All right. Okay, cool. So we're going to be picking... Oops. I don't need to see my whiteboard. We're going to be picking various different movements tonight per song, and it'll give you a chance to explore per song. And tonight, what we're going to do... I'll start with a very broad category for the first... exercise, but you can make it as specific as you want or need to. But what we're going to work on to start is what we call gooey samurai, you know, or gooey warrior, or just gooey in general. And you imagine that, you know, in a good way, that, you know, like you're honey is poured all over you or something, and your gooeyness is you moving through that. Everything has kind of like a smear quality to it when you're in gooeyness. And so if you're really not sure, and if you're the sort that like you want to flow with this but you don't know what the hell I'm talking about, this would be just samurai without the goo. This is like just warrior movement without goo. This is gooiness, right? It's not just a change of pace, but do you see how I'm like making contact through it? Okay. All right. Gooey warrior, your exploration of that. Throughout the night, kind of almost like I'm teaching a movement class, I'll be calling out pointers. Normally, I would have you guys in the room with me, and those pointers would be based on things that I'm seeing or things that I've experienced before. But But tonight, I'm just going to be giving you pointers, hopefully not too many, going to help you have a new appreciation. The greatest single piece of advice I can give you for gooeyness right now is to think about the point of contact the hoop is making and how it is smearing around you. Like, even if I'm doing some kind of like open samurai where my fingers are, you know, flipped, I'm paying attention to the point of contact. Like, for me, it's the outside wall of the hoop that it's making, like, you know, on my stomach or... And that's how I find, that's how I find my gooey, okay? So just again, this would be like not gooey. See, that's super sharp, crisp. This is gooey. Some people have a more natural gooeyness. Some people are more staccato. So I'm going to shut up and let you listen. To the core now, onto the waist. Swing. There we go. Okay. We're going to move on to the waist. So in these classes, we'll be moving through different phases, so don't get attached to one thing. Of course, you know, if you're watching this on replay, if you really like something, you just pause it, stay there for a day, and then watch it the rest tomorrow. But we're going to move into the Waste Two thing right now. And tonight our focus is going to be on two birds. And all that really means is, what are our hands doing? How are the hands moving? People don't seem to believe me, but I'm convinced that what we're doing for our bodies in the future is going to be amazing. That what the older folk need the most when they, you know, take on those years is coordination, flexibility, response time, all the things that hooping is doing for us right now. Guided flow, I suggest that you reverse. And then release. Take the hoop anywhere you want to, up and down. Just keep your focus on your hands. If it helps to imagine them flying like birds, why not? Right. Look up, look up, look up, look up, look up, look up. You'll be amazed how different hooping can feel when you look up. Sweet. Good job. If you're just joining us, this is a guided flow class, which means I suggest a technique for each song, one technique per song. Right now we're working on moving the hands. Well, we're not really working on it, we're playing with it. Okay, sweet. Okay. Okay. All right, we're going to pop over to wait, this will be a funky one. right now we're going to work on and I realize this may not be for everybody, but we're going to work on going back to that older person, the idea of hops. The hops are where, you know, I'm just teaching my hand how to move from one side of the hoop to the other side of the hoop or down or whatever. These are just hops. If they hurt after a while, see if you can downsize, you know, your hoop a little bit, or if you, most hoopers have multiple hoops. This is kind of small hoop stuff for some people. And there's this thing with hops, and the thing is with the hop with hops, you work on them for minutes or sometimes hours, but in your street flow, in any given moment, it might come out once in a half second, nobody saw, you go like that, but you spent time working on it. Hops are kind of like that, and so what I want you to do is, if you can, is just take the next, you know, 3 minutes to work on hops, and then we'll move on. This is me switching orientations. Thumbs down, thumbs up, thumbs down, thumbs up. Left, right. These are hops to the other side. These are hops to the other side. Pulling my right hand, pulling back to my left. Left hand, pulling back to my right. You guys, remember, if you like this hops, this was the old hoop half days. I'm holding the hoop in my left hand on my right side. It's across my body. That's called left far, left hand far. This is right near. Right near. This is left near. This would be right far. And I used to call this out like a sensei. And everybody in New York, it started in New York, they would all say, ha! It was completely their idea, but they would say, ha! So I'd go like, left near, and they go, ha! And I'd say, right near, and they go, ha! Right far, ha! Left far, ha! Right far, left far. Exactly what coin flipping or what how you mean it right there, but you definitely can put some palm spin on this and it'll flip over you. Watch me. I'm gonna pull it back. It'll flip over though. It's gonna fold in slow motion over me. Hit your cat three times. Oh, Jackie, come on, Jackie. Oh, I don't think you did it out of frustration, Jackie. Hey, I want to say that this is my this picture tonight was taken by Beth Lavender, who some of you guys know, and this was at St. Simon's, and that's actually me. I know most of the time I don't, but that's actually me in there, and I was being funny. I know it looks like kind of cheesy, but I was being funny, but it with Beth and her photography at work. Okay. All right. So, oh yeah, breaks. I'm on the waist here. I don't know why that's happening. All right, I'm on the waist here. And I'm going to break and break and break and break. We're going to do breaks, obviously, on the next song. To be super clear, a break is when you stop the momentum. And you can send it back. You don't have to, but you stop the momentum. That is the break. This is the break. Okay? Now, this is a break. Well, if I do two-handed breaks, this would be a break without a reverse. Right? That's a break without a reverse. But these are breaks. And every time you do a break, you know, you can't, it's not something that you manufacture. And so when you're doing them, each break can be perfect or imperfect. And when you're doing a series of breaks like this, when I'm going back and forth, what they call a fit, it's kind of like each time the next break sort of help repairs what the last break did. If I'm trying to learn a second current, you know, like the opposite direction in my core hooping, I can send it in second current, reverse it back to first, send it in second current, reverse it back. So it makes learning second current a lot, you know, less noisy. Let's bring on the song. God, I'm hitting you guys twice with the drum spider today. Sometimes when I'm in the mood for him, it's awesome. Okay. So of course we're doing breaks at the waist. You can obviously drift off from me and, you know, do any breaks that you want to. A student in a workshop once, and she said, I like breaks, I like watching you do them, but to me they feel very jarring and very, you know, staccato. And I was like, well, maybe what would a non-staccato break look like? What would a less jarring break look like? And it was really quite beautiful. I mean, she was very creative, but, you know, for her, the less jarring break, of course we had bigger hoops back then, was to kind of catch it and release it. Even if you're advanced, you can do this upstairs with the with the shoulders, this kind of catch and release type break. Second, we called them push breaks, but that term kind of fell off after a while, even in my class. But a push break used to be when you would push the hoop away from you into a grip like that. That was a push break. Of course, I'm stopping it in samurai there. So a push break is when I just, you know, I'm imagining pushing the hoop off of the core so I don't stop it. Well, it's neck like on the core, I'm pushing it off.
tough. You know, away from the jarring idea, you know, let's just say you don't think you're fast enough or strong enough to create the break that you want, then just let go of that break. Let go of that idea. And think about just what can you do with your hoop size? What break can you achieve? And maybe you just need to slow it down. And then, of course, if we want to tie it all together, if I make a break and I'm gooey out of it, then that's a whole nother way of moving, right? So I make a break and then I'm gooey out of it. If there's something you want to work or hone in your game, just commit to it for a whole song like we're doing here. Okay, like I said, we're going to do one more drum spider track. I love that style when you break it with one hand, and that's a new move for me that I learned from you. Sweet, yep. That's kind of what we're talking about with the whole push-break thing. You know, this is the samurai technique. I don't know if you can see it in the bird's eye there, but you see how I'm standing in the middle, top right corner there? That's, you know, that's a pretty good samurai. I need to move my monitor, y'all. That's why I keep looking off. Okay, all right, let's go. Yeah, okay, we're going to go do what we like with shoulders. Come up. Solid song of shoulders. Sweet, Danielle. Oh, sweet. We're on shoulders right now. I'll try to lay off the pointers a little bit, but I want to, if they're helping, and they seem to be. Says hello. I cannot see who's here and who's not here, so I definitely appreciate it. Let me say what's up. I am Danielle. Long time. That's great. To take, but most of the time with shoulders, the best advice I can give you is to relax. Because almost always people are focusing so hard that they're creating constriction. They're creating these tight spaces, right? And of course, you can never relax when someone tells you to, but that's kind of what needs to happen there, is to relax. And sometimes it can help to relax the hands, you know, like to think, I'm just going to keep them relaxed. I'm not going to break anything with the grip of my hands right now. Yeah, well, this is all on SoundCloud, and I will... if you like that kind of sound, Jennifer, he is the man for you. He has this kind of, like, Celtic... I don't know. I don't want to mislabel it. He's got this kind of old-school folk vibe. Everybody is doing well, and let me make sure I haven't missed anybody. Sweet. Okay, so for this next exercise, we've got about two more of these that I had planned. We're going to do some vertical rolling right now, and this is when I'm just rolling the hoop around a hand. And this is one of those things a lot like waist hooping where it can be easy, like, you know, to feel like you're not working on it getting better if you're just doing this. But trust me, as a teacher, as a hooper, as a mover, that the sort of coordination and the different strengths that you're developing just by doing something simple, like, I mean, you can imagine, like, if it's good for your, you know, if it's good for you horizontally, right, then it's probably going to be good for the arms too. And so what I want you to we're going to work on for the next exercise is vertical rolling, and that's when you're basically going to keep the hoop in a constant roll. This would be if I did a body roll out of this, but this is that old school move we've been working on forever. Roll, whoa, but I'm going to keep rolling. And then I've got a song that is the least rolling sounding song ever. Actually, no, you know what? We'll play this one. This will be better for this. I don't want to blow anyone's mind, but there are two currents in rolling, right? There's two currents. And it took me about 6 years of hooping before I realized that maybe I should go the other way when it comes to vertical rolling as well. I showed this at a workshop once, and people actually dug it, and it was a move. But you can stall and do a barrel roll. I'm not as flexible as I used to be, so prepare to not be wild. But I can swing into a barrel roll from that roll. So I'm here, and I'm rolling, and then in slow motion, I'm going to put both hands in the hoop there as it's rolling. Both hands. Boom. The hand that's holding the hoop. Somebody somewhere wants me to turn around. Show it to you this way. Whoa. Not the best for lights, but. Sweet, Sarah. Sweet. Thank you guys for chiming in, as always. Okay.
What you gonna do with all that junk?
All right. We're gonna definitely play that. But we're gonna do one more. All right. okay, so for this next song, you can pretty much pick anything, but what I'm gonna suggest is more staccato type movement or isolations. Like taking a second to work on isolations. Boom, 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 boom. Or staccato type movements. All right. The song's crazy. And then we're going to go into a free hoop after this, so. I like all your comments. I think it's great. Sweet Jackie. Oh, and some of you might not realize, you might not know all the rules. If you have a breakthrough, you have to tell us. We are the witness.
Hi.
Alright guys, so we're gonna move into Free Hoop. I've got some funky songs for the Free Hoop. What you gonna do with all that junk? All that junk. Thank you guys for joining me, I really appreciate it. You got it, Nina. Have a great night, everybody. We're gonna Free Hoop. I think I got about 3 songs worth of music here. Thank you so much. I do it on the daily. They treat me really nicely. They buy me all the ice. Dolce and Gabbana, Fendi and Madonna. Karen, they be sharing all their money. Got me wearing fly. Girl, I ain't asking. They say they love my ass. And 7 jeans to religion. I see no mistake is given. So I keep on taking. And no, I ain't taking. We can keep on dating. I keep on demonstrating. Interested in the music, you want to find a way to find it. What you gonna do with all that junk inside it? I'ma get you drunk, get you love drunk off my hump. Get all that ass inside him. Okay, guys, the music is the link there. It's live, it's public, you should be able to find it. No problem. If we're still on Facebook, but if we are, thank you guys for joining us on Facebook. Thank you for Twitch. If anybody's watching on Twitch, I'm horrible at Twitch. But I just tried to update all my info, and I think it should be good to go. I will be uploading a high-quality version. You can watch this in HD, and that'll be up tomorrow, about 14 hours from now. Delicious. You guys are welcome, thank you. Next class will be Thursday. Thursday. You guys are very welcome, thank you very much. Thank you guys for the donations, I appreciate that. Reba, Rebecca, thank you guys for joining. Thank you, Sarah, as always. Big love. Thank you, guys. Appreciate that. Next song will definitely be the last song I'm going to fade out while it's on. I actually think it's maybe a little too crazy for a last song, but we're just going to stay here. Song of the night. Thank you, guys. Thank you. care. Have a great night.